video production company and a multimedia production company called the Neely Group. And we use the Amiga in a variety of creative ways, mainly in the corporate communications area. The Amiga is an extremely powerful computer. It can do a vast number of creative things. If you can think of it, if you can think of an application, especially in the video and graphic area, you can do it. I can't, you know, being a video producer, I can't even do a simple video without putting Amiga graphics in it, because as far as titling and creative screens and so on, the potentials are unlimited. The limitation usually comes in your imagination in figuring out what to do with it, because it will do whatever you want it to do. You just have to be able to think of it.
The Amiga is heralded in the video community for delivering video titling, graphics, and animation at very attractive prices. It's become an essential tool for broadcast, cable, post-house, and in-house production facilities throughout the world. The Amiga delivers a wide range of fonts, thousands of colors, professional transitions between titles, excellent text edge smoothing, microspacing between letters, large file storage capacity, and flexibility in hardware and software expansion. There's no better professional investment than an Amiga titling system. Here's a complete titling system. The computer is an Amiga with 3 megabytes of RAM and a 40 megabyte hard disk. We have a color monitor and a genlock. There is a range of genlocks available for the Amiga. For software, this configuration includes a video titling program and a paintbox program for adding two-dimensional graphics and animations to the screen. The configuration is ideal for in-house production, post-house, and cablecast uses such as weather and news graphics. It can supply excellent titles for the video you work hard to produce.
Services. The original concept of what I wanted to build was a multimedia company, a company where if you created a graphic image once, it shouldn't matter what the medium was that you prepared or printed that image on. And with our Amiga systems, for example, we can create a corporate logo for a customer. We can create it once on the Amiga. We then have the option within our company to spit it out as 35 millimeter slide, 4x5 transparency, camera ready art, plate ready film, positive film for silk screening, videotape to be merged into other images. This piece was produced very early this spring, and it was produced entirely on the Amiga. And one of the unique things about this is that the original artist conception was done with Intellux paint on an Amiga terminal, about an inch and a half deep by an inch wide, and that this poster was created and produced entirely to plate-ready film without ever touching human hands. I use this computer to run my business, to produce professional-level graphics, to sell them to corporate clients, and to sell them in a high-end professional marketplace.
Artists think with their eyes and hands. They make a mark, view it, and then adjust it. Use the Amiga with your eyes and hands to develop brochures, business presentations, video graphics, training materials, and many other creations. A variety of input and output devices such as cameras, scanners, graphic tablets, digitizers, film recorders, and color printers are available to let the Amiga work directly with your existing materials. An Amiga graphic system provides creative tools for working artists. A suggested Amiga art and graphics configuration is an Amiga with 3 megabytes of RAM and a 40 megabyte hard disk. A color monitor gives you a sharp RGB image to work with. For software, we suggest one or two inexpensive two-dimensional paint programs which give differing and complementary functions. Useful additions include a camera, digitizing software, and a color printer. Some illustrators may prefer to replace the mouse with a graphics tablet. Work with your authorized Commodore business dealer to configure the system that's right for you.
I use a computer because because I do a lot of storyboarding. Before, when I was just making print storyboards, here's an example of a print storyboard for Three Men and a Baby. I used to basically walk into the client and show them a print storyboard. The program I use the most to create storyboards and stuff is a program called Deluxe Paint 3. It was a great program. It's gotten better and better. Now it has animation capabilities. Computer for the creative mind, I think it's right on, you know? In a regular kind of marker comp or airbrush comping world, ideas get away before you can get them down on paper. You know, with the Amiga, you can create an image and save it off to disk and be on to the next one before those ideas get away.
The animation you're watching was created on the Commodore Amiga. Only the Amiga can deliver texture mapping, ray tracing, sophisticated three-dimensional modeling, and real-time playback capability at such a low price. Genlock the Amiga with the VCR and record animations for your video productions. Quickly create full-color, two-dimensional animations for impromptu business presentations. Whatever your professional animation needs, the Amiga is equipped to meet them and to surpass your expectations. Here is an Amiga configured for animation. For rendering speed, you want an Amiga with a 68030 processor. To hold your animations, we suggest 4 megabytes of 32-bit RAM, and to look at your images, a good RGB monitor. As for software, a good animation package offering such features as three-dimensional modeling, texture mapping, and animation. You'll also want a two-dimensional paint program.
Using the Amiga and a MIDI interface, I can connect to any MIDI device, MIDI instrument like synthesizers and drum machines, and I can create very sophisticated music, like this piece, for example. I'm a composer, arranger, and I write music for video, corporate videos, and TV commercials, as well as some radio commercials. All you have to do is learn how to use the particular piece of software, which usually uses some kind of a musician interface in a way, so if it's a sequencer, you'll have play or record, things that you're used to. If you see transpose, invert, a musician knows what all these terms mean. It also lets you experiment a lot more than if you're on a busy schedule in a recording studio and musicians are there. You don't want to spend any time experimenting. These ideas can be, you know, using a powerful editing sequencer like KCS Level 2, I can reverse a track or flip all the pitches very quickly and just hear how that would sound if I paste this with that. I usually synchronize to the VCR so I can get the film and the computer in sync all the time. But the Amiga is a multitasking machine, so I can run all these programs at the same time, which is like a very effective music workstation. I have the sound editor that lets me access all the sounds that I have in my synthesizers and modify them in any way. And I also can use the notation programs to write parts for musicians if I need to use live musicians in the session. Musicians interact with your work in a way that is very special, and sometimes if it's a very good musician, it's good. Sometimes it's not exactly what you wanted. When working with the Amiga, it's really like working with the smallest musician that can play all the instruments.
Professional music configuration will combine an Amiga with a color monitor and a MIDI interface. This can be connected with one or more of your keyboard or rack synthesizers for composition, recording, and performance. Software you'll need will include composition programs for your music and librarian programs for your sounds. This configuration assists you in creating whatever music you want, even with a small budget. It includes a very affordable Amiga with extra memory, hard disk, and a MIDI interface. Because of the Amiga's special sound chips, you can create and play back sampled or synchronized music for four instruments. Software you'll need will include composition programs for your music. Use the MIDI interface to expand the system to include your keyboards.
Here at Design Mirage, we're an advertising agency. We specialize in doing corporate advertising and retail advertising, and we use the Amiga basically in all areas of our company. One of the nice things about the Amiga is it's not only a computer that the art department can use for doing graphics design and desktop publishing and animations for video, but it's also a computer that we can use to keep track of our customers, to do our accounting, to write letters, to do all types of business functions with.
As the office manager of the company, I use the Amiga strictly for business purposes. What's nice here is because we are both retail and we are a service-oriented company, the point of sale icon provides for, say, a person coming in and purchasing something over the counter that day. You can hit point of sale here and invoice that customer right then and there, and it credits it to your accounts receivable, and it's done. Basically, what the Amiga has helped me to do is eliminate my adding machine, my typewriter, my pencil, and especially my eraser, and my yards and yards of adding machine tape. And now, all that I really have on my desk is my coffee cup, my picture of my 7-month-old baby, and my Amiga.
The first reason to use the Amiga for your office work is that there is a wide variety of Amiga software, including spreadsheets, word processors, databases, business graphics programs that will support your computer needs and increase your productivity. The second reason is that if you already have MS-DOS files, you can import those files to an Amiga containing a bridge board and run your favorite MS-DOS software on the Amiga, Lotus 123, DBase 4, and many other MS-DOS programs. The third reason is that the bridge board allows you to use the advanced capabilities of the Amiga, such as AmigaDOS multitasking and its palette of 4,096 colors, to extend the functionality of your MS-DOS files beyond your MS-DOS machine's capabilities. Extend the power of your MS-DOS applications by running them on the Amiga. For office productivity, we suggest the Amiga with its color monitor and a bridge board that allows you to run both MS-DOS and AmigaDOS programs simultaneously. This is a great configuration for getting the best of both worlds.
We've been using AmigaVision to easily create systems that link together graphics, animation, sound, and video to create informational displays for public access. We were never able to do this with such ease before. This is an example of something we might create. We like to use very colorful graphics, real-time animation, so the user is entertained and likes using the system. This is all created on the Amiga and can be changed very easily. So if you have to change some information, updating is very easy and very fast.
There are more communicators than there are programmers. For the communicating majority, Commodore presents AmigaVision. AmigaVision harnesses video, graphics, sound, animation, text, music, and more for the purposes of presenting, interactive teaching, data gathering, demonstrating, marketing, training, archiving, locating, and more. AmigaVision, the single tool for important communications. To author with AmigaVision, we suggest a CPU with an RGB monitor, genlock, video disc player, optional external speakers, and audio and video digitizers. Minimum software would include AmigaVision, of course, as well as a two-dimensional paint package. Delivery systems can be much more simple, requiring only a CPU, RGB monitor, genlock, video disc player, and AmigaVision.
Please ask a salesperson to assist you. Please ask a salesperson to assist you.